Okay, so in this video, we'll be talking about inverse Laplace transform. So we'll be trying to define what is the inverse of a Laplace transform, and also try to solve some problems involving the inverse Laplace transform. Okay, so we know that the definition for a Laplace transform. Okay, so the definition of a Laplace transform. So we have the Laplace of f. Is big letter. So f of t is equal to the integral of e to the negative st f of t dt with limits from 0 to infinity, which is also equal to f of s. So don't be confused with the letters. So from small f to big f, because it just only mean that the initial function has been transformed to another function. So as you can see, the initial function is in terms of t, then the output function is now in terms of s. Okay, so for example, if I'm going to take the Laplace, the inverse Laplace transform, so the inverse, I guess there is no inverse there. Okay, so sorry for that. So this should have not been a inverse on that part. Okay, so if you are going to take the inverse Laplace transform of this one, because this is the transform of this Laplace, okay, so it will just be equal to f of. So this is now the definition of a Laplace transform, or the inverse Laplace transform. Okay, so for example, if we have the, using our table, Laplace transform table, we have the inverse Laplace of s over s squared plus k squared. So we know from our table, this is this one, this s over s squared plus k squared is equal to the Laplace transform of cosine kt. So we should just get that one as cosine kt. And that will be our solution, or our answer for that certain example. So another property of a Laplace transform is that if we have different terms, so inverse Laplace transform of c1 f1 of s plus c2 f2 of s, so you could just get the individual Laplace transform of each. So you have inverse Laplace of c1 f1 of s plus inverse Laplace of c2 f2 of s, and the answer will just be the same. Okay, then another, we have a very useful property of a Laplace transform. We know that, maybe we should write here this part. Okay, we know that f of s is equal to the integral of e negative st f of t dt with limits from 0 to infinity. This is coming from the definition of a Laplace transform. Okay, so suppose if we have f s minus a, so we could have our integral transform into negative s minus a t f of t dt. So if you are going to separate this one, so we will have this one, we'll have integral of e to the negative s t e to the negative a to the a t, so this is plus, so it will be a t f of t dt. Now, if you look closely, so this one here, so we know from the fact that the Laplace, this one, the Laplace of S, F of S, there is Laplace of F of S is equal to Ft. So, and our Ft here, this one, so this is our F of S, this part here. So we could say that Fs minus A F of S minus A will be equal to, so this one is F of S, so you will left with this one, so this is equal to E raised to the power of AT F, so this is equal to F of T, or the Laplace transform of F of T. Okay, so we have the inverse Laplace transform of F of T. So this theorem is very useful when we are going to solve common inverse Laplace transforms. Okay, so I believe that will be all for this video and the explanation of the introduction to inverse Laplace transform. The next few videos will have example involving this type of concepts. Okay, so thank you for watching. I hope you know something, and as always, enjoy learning.